Welcome to HRO Milwaukee's Superfest, which was held September 29th and 30th. The event was so large that HRO came up with some off-site parking and even rented a very nice shuttle bus to get you there. Once you got in the store, you realized how busy it actually was, and bargains and special pricing everywhere, and a really nice vendor show in the back. If you've never been to HRO in Milwaukee before, one thing you'll notice is for a ham radio store, it's huge, and one of the cleanest ham radio stores I've ever seen. There's some real store pride at HRO in Milwaukee. One area that I like is the demo area, where you can try out just about every radio that's available, and where you can get real hands-on advice. So let's step out of the storefront and go to the back, where the vendor area is. HRO Superfest was very well attended, and most of the popular vendors were there, including ICOM, showing off the 9100, as well as the new 7300, and the IC2730 dual-bander, as well as the very popular ID51A. Yaesu had a very nice display, including the DX3000 and the DX1200 HF radios, as well as System Fusion radios, including the 2DR handheld and the 400DR mobile, as well as the 3200 and the 25R and 65R handhelds. Kenwood was also showing off their TS480, as well as the flagship TS990, as well as some nice mobiles like the TM281 and TMD710. And then from ARRL headquarters, ARRL marketing manager Bob Enderbitson, NQ1R, as well as Kermit Carlson, W9XA, Central Director, and Pat Moretti, KA1RB, the Wisconsin Section Manager, all manning the ARRL booth. There was some new and innovative stuff there as well, including SDR Play, a nice little SDR receiver. There was some displays for antennas. Gap had a nice display, as well as Comet showing off their vast assortment of antennas, and also Larson and Pulse. BioEnergo Batteries was there to show off all their neat lightweight batteries, and you have to stop by West Mountain Radio to see all the neat power distribution stuff, as well as some of the other accessories that they sell. There was a very good demonstration of Ham Radio Deluxe, and a nice demo that you could take a test drive with. And let's not forget TimeWave with all their accessories. And if you need a radio programmed, RT Systems can help. And some of the local clubs and organizations showed up, like the Milwaukee Repeater Club, which has what they call a sandbaggers net every afternoon. And the Racine Kenosha Aries group was showing off their communications trailer with enough batteries to power it for a considerably long time. And those batteries power quite a few radios in all kinds of different modes. There's also enough hard points on top to put up just about any antenna you can think of. The Washington County Aries Club was also represented. From the Salvation Army, Saturn was there. The Wisconsin Amateur Radio Club had a very nice display. The West Dallas Amateur Radio Club was promoting the Wisconsin QSO Party, held next year on March 11th. And the Milwaukee Amateur Radio Society had a nice display showing off their voting and repeater system. And let's not forget the birthday club. The Milwaukee Radio Amateurs Club is celebrating their 100th birthday this year. Their table was full of quite a bit of history from the club, including the original certificate from the ARRL. They even had a nice little forum with a presentation of the history of the Milwaukee Radio Amateurs Club. They also showed off their trailer, the W9RH communications trailer, which is running a special event station, W9RH/100. And Bob Enderbitson, NQ1R, celebrated their 100th anniversary with a cake-cutting ceremony. And let's not forget the Boy Scouts, who supplied the food and the beverage during Superfest. And that's HRO Milwaukee's Superfest 2017. From Milwaukee, Wisconsin, this is Dan, N9LVS, 73.